Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Today we're going to be trying out a bait that's new to us. The bait's about a year old. It's called the Strike King Hybrid Hunter. I haven't been able to find this bait until recently. I guess they've been flying off the shelves everywhere. But guys, this Hybrid Hunter, if you've never seen one, it's a crankbait. You'll notice it's got a funny looking little squared off bill on the front of it. But guys, what this does is this bait is supposed to come through grass and cover a lot easier. It's got a nice tight wobble on it. It's got a good rattle to it as well. So guys, we're gonna get this tied on. We're gonna try out this Hybrid Hunter, so you stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. All right guys, thanks again for joining us today here for the Hybrid Hunter. I'm gonna pair this up with it's a medium heavy action with a fast tip Abu Garcia crankbait rod that I like to use. It's a Vengeance model, and I'm throwing this retrieving this with a Black Max. This one is a it's got five bearings and it's 6-4-1 on the ratio. And I'm going to be tying this thing on here with a, I don't know what you call this knot. I've seen a lot of people tie it, and I've started tying it myself. I like it pretty good. You just bring your line up like so. You're going to pinch your line and double it over, and then I'm going to wrap around that thing about five times. And I'm gonna go back through the loop here at the top. If any of you guys know what this knot's called, drop me a message there in the comments and let me know. And you just take and pull that dude tight, give it a little bit of moisture. Always pull my tag in first and then pull my main line, and then I pull my tag in again. It seems to work out pretty good. If any of you guys know what this knot's called, just drop me a comment there and let me know. I see a lot of people tying it. Actually was out at OHIV a month ago or so, and was fishing with Brandon Burks's dad, and he was tying it, and I said, man, I've seen a lot of people tying that. How do you tie that knot? And he showed me, so I've been using it and I've had good luck with it. But for now, we're going to get out here on this pond out here and chunk this Hybrid Hunter and see what we can do. So you guys stay tuned. All right guys, here goes our first cast with a Hybrid Hunter. I got some little brush piles right out there. I'm gonna reel this thing real slow because, like I said, it dives about 5 foot deep. I can feel it tapping the bottom. It's supposed to have a real tight wiggle. It's supposed to come through grass really well. And this pond has got a beaucoup of grass in it. You can see we grabbed a little bit. I've been seeing a few fish popping around out here since we've been here on the top and stuff, but it's supposed to be a real good all around tight bait. Got a good tight wiggle and it's got a big loud rattle in it. So see if we can get anybody interested in it here. I may only be eating frogs today, who knows? They're sure jumping around under them trees and things over there in the shade. See what we can do with this thing. famous bank with it. Oh, there, we must have thrown it right in that one's mouth. He liked it for sure. He was kind of hungry for it. He said, let me try out that hybrid hunter. Not too bad for our first hybrid hunter fish. Little bass, about a pound and a half, 2 pounds maybe. Pretty nice little fish. Well, that was number one. Let's see if we can get out here and find us another one. This bait floats, so anytime you stop the retrieve, it'll come back to the top. You can kind of hold your rod up and probably work it close to the top. Like I said, it's got a good tight wiggle with it. Skips a little bit. All right, guys, we're out here. I'm trying to keep y'all out of the sun and see myself in the camera. Trying out this hybrid hunter. Man, these fish are just tearing it up around the banks. Be a great day to be throwing a frog, probably. But I just got this bait. I have looked for it forever. I just recently found it. So I'm really, really dying to try it out. It does seem to come through the grass pretty well. You know, of course it's got treble hooks on it, so it's gonna grab a little bit. Can't hardly help that. That just kind of goes with the game. This is kind of like a shad color. It's kind of clear at the bottom. Got almost a blue-green back on it. Supposed to dive down about 5 foot. I know I ain't but about 5 foot out there, so we should be pretty close to the bottom. I'd figure they'd be chasing bait fish and brim and such since it's about 3 days after the full moon in September. This is usually about the last time that the brim will spawn. We ought to catch fish right here. Yep, right there. He followed it right in and got it. Easy fella. He bit it right at the bank. He said, no, 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 you're not gonna get away from me. I wish I'd have brought my pliers over here. Got 2 left in him here if I can get them out. There we go. Well, that's another good little pound and a half, 2 pound fish on the old hybrid hunter. We're gonna throw across this little old flat. See if we can't wiggle back this way and catch us one. Oh, there he is right there, guys. Man, I'm telling you, he attacked it right at the bank, too. See? He wasn't gonna let it get away from him. There you go, the hook is out. Fish ain't hurt and I ain't hurt. So that's a good deal. Well, that's three on the hybrid hunter. Of course, I'd like to have done caught 30, but that's three, so y'all hang in there. Looks like we need to make sure that we fish this thing all the way to the bank. Because I've had two literally hit it within 2 foot of the bank, and then I had another one blow up on it right at the bank. There's another one. Little booger there got a little air out there. He liked it. Man, I'm telling you, they are just chasing these fish all around the bank around here. Got a rear hook in him. Got a front hook in him. I'm gonna try to move y'all over there a little closer if I can kind of angle you away from the sun so maybe y'all can see some of these. That's number four. Hey, they turning on to it. All right, let's see what else we can come up with here. Some fish chasing bait or something over there up in them weeds. Oh, there's one right there. I'll tell you what, guys, these fish ain't very big, but they sure are a lot of fun to learn with. You bring a kid out here, you put one of these lures on, or any kind of lure, man, they'll just have a blast out here where they can just come out here and just catch them one after another. It changes their whole outlook on fishing. Or your wife, if your wife don't like going fishing because she don't ever catch nothing. My wife don't ever have that problem. She usually outfishes me. But I'm just saying, if that is your situation, find you a place like this, treat your landowner right, and you'll have a fishing spot from now on. Funny action on it. Oh, there we go. There's another one. Another little cuss. He almost looks like the same one. But I don't think he's been hooked. I got a little fish poop on me there. All right, guys, we're gonna make this last cast. We're gonna wrap this thing up afterwards. I'm gonna throw right to kind of down here. There's a hump out there where two old pools used to meet together. Was the dam on one. See if we can't figure if one's out there or not. All right, guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Today we were previewing the Hybrid Hunter by Strike King. Caught four decent little fish on it out here for the pond. I appreciate you joining us. Guys, until next time, tight lines.